What a lovely turnout. What a lovely turnout. You guys are so jobless on a Sunday. You guys ready for the open mic? Yes? Can we have a round of applause for T-Trove, please? Great, great. Talking about Facebook pictures, you know, you can guess the relationship status of a guy by the Facebook, activity he goes through. You know? Have you guys thought about this? See, for example, if a guy is just liking a pic, he's cool. Okay? He's not desperate and he's probably, you know, in a relationship. If he likes and comments on a girl's Facebook picture, if he likes and comments, wowee, stunning, and all these in capital letters and wrong spellings, he is single and desperate. If the girl thanks him back and he continues the conversation, he's single, desperate, and optimistic. If you see a comment, you know, on a girl's picture that, guess who took this pic? He's single and friend-zoned. And if a person likes a picture on Facebook, or if a person sees a picture on Facebook of a girl and doesn't like it, nor comment, but WhatsApps her, that good pic, he's married. And if he continues the conversation on WhatsApp, he's married and optimistic. Marwari's in the house, give me a cheer. That's what money sounds like. You're Marwari, sir?
Yeah.
You are Marwari. What do you do?
I'm working with a bank.
You're working with a bank? No business? Oh my God. Pseudo Marwari. You're working in the corporate sector. Which bank?
HSBC.
HSBC. What are your work timings?
10 to 8.
10 to 8? You know, I work with a company and my work timings are till the earth revolves around the sun. So simple. Talking about corporates, you know, corporates make a career out of pretending to look serious. That's all. You know, you work in HSBC Bank, right? So you have set systems, set processes, everything. All you have to do is write obvious emails, make follow-up phone calls, and enter data. If you're doing all three, you're junior level. If you're doing the first two, you're mid-level. And if you're doing nothing, you're the boss. Incredible. My company has a very good retention policy, employee retention policy. It says, load the employee with so much bullshit that he doesn't have the time or the peace of mind to log on to Naukri.com. Are you guys ready for the first comic of the night? Please give it up for Priyam Ghosh.
Good evening, everyone. Good. Everything good. Very good, yeah. So yeah, I'm Priyam Ghosh, 16 years old and probably the youngest to do such things. Well, to introduce myself, I'm a national level badminton player and a national level quizzer. So basically, I'm a national level struggler. Yes, recently I was in Chennai to play the Junior National Badminton Championship. And my first round opponent was from Andhra Pradesh, Hyderabad, South India. And his name was Subramanyam Venkata Siddheswara Kidambi Abhimanyu Balagopal Abhinanda Chanakya Jagdish Jayaprakash Mithun Chakraborty Iyer. And everything that I said before Iyer was his initial. Yeah, and you know, I just don't get why do they have such big names. You know, they're so big that in fact, when you start writing a South Indian name and by the time you end up writing that name, you will feel that you've almost written a Bhagavad Gita in Tamil. Yeah, and they're so big, the names are so big that what if three South Indian men with big names walk into a bar, right? And suppose those three South Indians are Lakshman, Shiva, Rama, Krishna. That was not three, that was one. The second one is Krishnamachari Srikanth, and the third one is Muthaiah Muralidharan, right? What if these three South Indian men with big names walk into a bar? The bar gets closed. Reason? Overcrowded. Yeah. But, you know, whatever the South Indians do, you know, busy pronouncing their name, busy handling their lungis, busy cooking stuff with coconut oil, I admire them because they produce great comedians time and again. Like, for instance, K. Srikanth and Prabhu Deva. You know the name of the movie ABCD, anybody can dance, should have been YBCD. Because whenever I spotted Prabhu Deva saying the name of the movie, he said, anybody can dance. thank you. And this guy Prabhu Deva is planning to make a sequel to the movie Wanted. And I assume the name of the movie will be Unwanted because he's planning to cast Uday Chopra in it. But, you know, it will be unfair to just make fun of South India, right? So I'll make fun of every part of India, starting with the West people of Gujarat and Mumbai. You know, they just don't care, right? Chhor yaar. Like, you know, suppose a man comes to them. The first thing they'll do is to ask that man, hey, will you be profitable to my business? If that man says yes, he says, come, join. If that man says no, he says, get last man. And, you know, their only motto in life is to earn a lot of money, right? To earn a lot of money, go back home, relax, watch Tarak Mehta Ka Ulta Chashma, eat papra jalebi and go to Dandiyan Garba parties to have fun. But they at least go to Dandiyan Garba parties to have fun. People here in Bengal, go to Hilsa Festival to have fun. But talking about Bengal, Bengal have the most sincere neighbors, Bihar and Jharkhand. Buy one, get one free. And talking about Bengal, we Bengalis come to this world only to do four things in life. First of all, to attend a wedding party. Secondly, to eat and sleep for 23 hours a day. Thirdly, to create chaos at Cholek Stadium whenever East Bengal plays Mohun Bagan. And fourthly, to shout and tell people all over the country that Saurav Gangul and Rabindranath Tagore are Bengalis. Thank you. And this thing is happening in Kolkata, right? When do you really know that you're in Kolkata? I'll tell you when. When you go to a girl and ask her, who do you want to marry? Saurav Ganguly. When you go to a guy, ask him, who do you want to marry? Saurav Ganguly. Talking about Saurav Ganguly, talking about cricket, Indian cricket is again not doing well. Obvious from the fact that they're in abroad. I just don't know what happens to them when they're in abroad. I think they've become Mallika Sharawat. Sizzling in Bolly, struggling in Holly. Right? And, you know, but I feel the Indian cricketers can't do much because they have the option to choose between Raina and Dhawan, which is almost like choosing between Tushar Kapoor and Dino Moriya. Yeah. But I feel proud when someone like Mohammad Shami from Bengal is doing so well for India, right? Otherwise, that tall girl with long hair, just forgot her name. Jhulan Goswami's twin sister, Ishan Sharma. He used to do all the wrong things, right? All the wrong things. And people used to criticize him a lot. He's still being criticized. But I feel he's a great bowler. For he, not only can he reverse swing a ball, he also has the ability to reverse swing a whole match. And you know, Indians are batting so badly nowadays that they promoted Ishan Sharma up the order. It's like YRF casting Jackie Bhagnani expecting it to be a hit. Right? And Indians are batting so badly that even the Zimbabwean bowlers are calling themselves batsmen. And a few days back, I happened to meet a Zimbabwean cricketer and it was a funny situation. The reason why it was funny, because the Zimbabwean player had applied sunscreen on his face to avoid getting dark. Thank you, that was my set. This is Priyam Ghosh, 60 days old.
Give it up for Priyam Ghosh! Please put your hands together for Vaibhav Sethia. Okay, so I want to talk about my recent trip to Delhi. I recently went to Delhi and I figured, you know, like, it goes without saying how different the cultures in Delhi and Calcutta are, in general, Punjabis and Bengalis, right? But then here's the most, like, on a personal level, I felt a difference because whenever I'm in Calcutta, I feel I'm better looking in Calcutta. Like the Bengali men, thank you. Thank you so much. Even on a, like, you know, on a political level, like, you know, everything in Calcutta is about, like, Cholbina. Didi, do you want to get married? Na Cholbina. Didi, do you want a boyfriend? Na Cholbina. And on the other hand, in Punjab, everything is like, you know, like, you're more like, achadna yaar ki frak pehnda hai. They run more on, like, oh, tune meri girlfriend ki puppy kyun le li? Achadna yaar ki frak pehnda hai. Everything goes, like, first 3 years of college, sab, everyone's like sleeping with each other. Achadna yaar ki frak pehnda hai. That's how they roll for all their college. And you know, like, this is the thing, like, you know, a lot of Delhiites, they usually, like, you know, they tend to be aggressive people, like, you know, especially when it comes to their women. But then here's the thing, like, after every fight,
you would see that, you know, like a Punjabi probably comes out finally and he's with a broad chest, he'll come out and say, "Ab pehla thappad to maine mara na." And bongs will be like, "Pehla thappad tum mara. Pehla thappad tum mara. You are wrong." And you know, like how in general, like on the roads, we have those orange traffic cones. We call them orange traffic cones on the dividers. You know what they're called in Delhi? They're called VLC media player. Thanks a lot for coming tonight.
You know, DDLJ, my wife saw the movie, and in the evening when I came home, the first thing she said was, "Yaar, tum na utna romantic nahi rahe." मैंने कहा क्या हुआ? यार तुमने शाहरुख खान को देखा है? मैंने कहा देख, पहली बात, शाहरुख खान जिसके साथ रोमांटिक हो रहा है उसकी बीवी नहीं है। दूसरी बात, मुझे 5 करोड़ मिल रहे हो ना, मैं तेरे साथ क्या, तेरी मम्मी के साथ भी रोमांटिक हो जाऊंगा।